Ears. Welcome to the very first episode of Straight Talk with Ani and Amy
and Shelby.
And Shelby. A couple topics here we want to go over.
Yes, we do.
I'd like to ask you a couple questions.
Oh, okay.
You got this?
I got this.
All right.
Let's do this.
Tell me your best Meyer memory. So I get a call and he asks, what are you doing right now? And I said, working. And he said, okay, well, I'm coming down the parking lot and I have a gift for the office. He's in the black Cadillac pulling in and there's a giant teddy bear sticking out the window. And he's like, yeah, I'm so excited. I got it from Costco. And it was on sale, and I drove down 95 with it. And I was like, you were such a child.
With
it hanging out of the window. And then him hauling it up in here, just as happy as can be, just with this huge teddy bear that's three times his size.
Can you imagine another car down 95, seeing this teddy bear hanging out of the window?
That's so excited. So if you see the teddy bear in the movie room, now you know why it's there.
That's a great
story. He won't get rid of it.
I love that.
All right, so speaking of best memories, what's yours?
I think most recently, we had a coworker, Haley. She started with us when she was 16. Meyer just adored her, and she was just great. And so she had no prom date. So Meyer took it upon himself, as she's working in the clinic and he's working on a patient. It happens to be maybe a 16-year-old boy. And you hear him go, so, Johnny, do you have a prom date?
And he's mortified.
Oh my gosh. Haley is so mortified. She is in the back going, knock it off. Knock it off. And literally for a week, every single high school boy that came through this office, so, Bob, do you have a prom date? Because Haley doesn't have one either. And he went all the way in with this whole like gag. This is a testament to how awesome he is to his team. I mean, she at the time was mortified, but to this day, now in her mid-20s, I mean, it's one of her favorite stories.
I love that.
A few moments later.
I'm sweating.
Me too, and I'm in long sleeves.
So I have a feeling I know what you're gonna say to this, but I wanna ask you a question. What do you like most about working here? What makes it special for you?
For me, it's just how genuine and honest everyone is, not just Dr. Meyer, but everybody in this practice. We all make it an effort to be a team, to be a family. With us being that way with the team and him being like that with us, it translates to the patients. And I feel like we actually do have a really good patient base.
Yeah.
We really have a sense of community in this this office. We work together to make each other better, like genuinely care. People walk in, how was your weekend?
So I patient cried this morning. You know?
Yeah.
That mom just cried.
And, yes. And I feel like we're like Norm from Cheers, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Cheers.
I hate them.
We're not drinking.
much.
We're not drinking.
Not drinking much. It's like, that's one split between each.
It's a little.
It's a shot.
It's a little.
It's a shot.
No.
Yes.
It's mouthwash.
Let's get to the good stuff.
Okay.
You've been here for 19 and a half years.
Okay, hold on.
Your most bizarre patient story.
Please tell me.
I don't think we can say it on TV. Just say it.
A patient had asked if they got braces, if they could still provide pleasure.
The answer is yes.
Okay.
Wait, what kind of pleasure?
Oh, gosh.
pleasure
to their loved one. The other experience I have, which I love so much, is when my son, who at the time was probably 6, Dr. Meyer was doing a consultation on a new patient. It happened to be an adult male patient. My son was here after school. He just runs into the room. He opens up the door. Uncle Scotty, look what I can do. And he did literally every variation of an arm fart.
Did he nail it?
He nailed it.
Meyer
so well.
Proud.
The guy goes, sold. I'm sold. Put the braces on right now.
That kid was great. We talk about it to this day.
I love that.
Everybody knows that we put on the best events.
Sure do.
You've been here 13 years. Tell me what event you love the most.
Okay. So, I mean, aside from the white party, which is just so much fun, right? And you get to dress up, and you know I don't dress up. So the fact that I get to dress up is great. But aside from that one, the teacher party.
Yeah.
The teacher party is by far my favorite event. So fun. They're so appreciative.
Yeah.
We get to drink on the job.
Yeah. It's always so great. I love the teacher party. I mean, it started out at a place that no longer exists anymore.
Oh my God,
the Rumbar. I mean, had it at the Square Grouper. We've had it in Abacoa. Now we've had it the last couple years at Blue Point. The teachers have so much fun.
But really
honestly,
do.
We all know that that is the one event for the team. Like, they're not really working.
We're working,
but we're not working.
We're not.
And it's like a social event for us.
It really is.
And that's what I love about it.
Yeah. So give the people what they want. He's my boss. Dr. Meyer's my boss. Tell us about Scotty. He's your bro.
Oh, gosh. So I can tell you that Scotty has been an entrepreneur at such a young age. He used to sell worms. Wow, I'm not kidding. He would go out and he would catch worms.
Keep a straight face.
Yeah. He'd put them in this styrofoam cup and he'd have them in our garage refrigerator and he had a sign out by the door. This is the honor system. People don't do this anymore. And we're saying, just leave a quarter. Guys would drive by, grown ass men would drive by.
Sorry, I can't say ass.
They would go into our garage, leave a quarter, and just take a styrofoam thing of worms to go fishing.
Oh my God, that is so sweet.
Yeah,
Small town, Shelby, Ohio,
right there. A small town, but that was actually up in Lake Erie.
Oh, yeah,
it was. I mean, that was probably a young childhood story.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, he's funny. We all know he's got the best sense of humor.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if I've ever shared this with you. I had kissed my first boy, and he happened to see me kissing this boy. Later on that week, that day, I had a rash on my arm. And I walked up to him and I said, I have this rash on my arm. I don't know what it is. And he, oh my God. Oh my gosh. I go, what? What is it? He goes, it's VD. Yeah, VD. I mean, I'm probably 9. I don't know what VD is, right? I go home, I'm crying. Can you imagine your daughter walking up to you, your 9-year-old, 10-year-old daughter going, Mom, I'm
I'm gonna pee my pants.
My mom just goes, Scott. I don't think kissed another boy for years after that.
I'm sorry. Oh, okay,
it's done.
Oh, God, cut.
So that's it. That's our Q&A. Okay.
That's it for now, folks.
That's it.
Until next time, keep smiling
and get your bite just right.
Cheers.
Cheers to all of you.
Thank you.